Well, I looked and stuff, but we don't have that kind of stuff usually.
I could sure use some.
Where would you put it?
Oh, no problem. We rotate the stock out with the old and with the new. But this one here, it's my pride. It's been on 4 years, 2 months. The rest of them, I just kind of keep them going. Kind of working up a harmonious relationship with them in equilibrium. Have a seat.
Sure.
Pop-Tart, there's red ones, blue ones over there.
Oh, no. No, thanks. So, what is this, some kind of psychic TV type?
Well, we all know the psychic powers of the televised image, but we need to capitalize on it and make it work for us instead of us working for it. Well, like, to me, my thing is a video image is much more powerful and useful than an actual event. Like, back when I used to go out, when I was last out, I was walking down the street. This guy, like, came barreling out of a bar, fell right in front of me, and he had a knife right in his back, landed right on the ground. And, well, I have no reference to it now. I can't refer back to it. I can't press rewind. I can't put it on pause. I can't put it on slow-mo and see all the little details. And the blood, it was all wrong. It didn't look like blood. Hue was off, and I couldn't adjust the hue. There I was seeing it for real, but it just wasn't right. And I didn't even see the knife impact on the body. I missed that part.
Bad.
Yeah. Well, I got something to show you. I just got this new tape. Get some contacts of mine. It's by this grad student over in the history department. Did you hear about him? He took his whole thesis committee hostage.
No.
True, it's unbelievable. Took him hostage, a SWAT team came in and offed him.
No.
And it's just no one's heard about it. It's not getting out. Anyway, he made this tape like just 15, 20 minutes before he went before the grad committee because he knew they weren't gonna okay his research. It was just way too radical and way beyond anything they were doing.
What was his thesis on?
You know, I don't know. I'm just really not sure. Something about a Bronze Age coming in the 90s. I'm just not sure what he is up to.
Each individual has this absurd notion, this predisposition.
Hey, it looks like John Hinckley.
He has some eternal significance, that he has this unending potential, this dormant potential, this stupid idea that 95% of the brain is unused, and that if you could tap into that, we could just have Superman or something absurd like that. All it does is frustrate man. All it does is remind him of his limitations and frustrate him. It's just a concoction of lies, a dynamic that drives men to do things.
Yeah, let me fast forward to the part where he blows away his camera. It's pretty good.
Every action is a positive action, even if it has a negative result. What could be better than a short, uncomplicated life that goes out with the blaze of glory? Rock and roll.
Must have been on to something, man.
Yeah, it was. So this is a dub of my copy. You think you'd want to tape of this?
Yeah. Friends in Kansas.
If you think he'd get this out, I think it really should be shown.
Oh yeah, definitely. But look, I gotta go. Thanks a lot.
Keep looking for those TVs.
Yeah, TVs. I'll let you know when we get some.
Sure. I'll be here. Thank you.
thunder of his horse's hooves is loud and loud and louder. At the midnight hour, down the road that leads to Sleepy Hollow, across the bridge, he goes galloping, 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 always searching, always seeking. And if you stand on the bridge at the wrong hour, the hour when he rides by, his great cloak sweeps round you, he swings you to his saddle bow, and then forever you must ride. And always his cold arms round you, clasping you into the cavity of his bony chest.